You've probably heard by now about the concept of a software bill of materials, but if you haven't seen one or have any idea of how they're created, this is your chance to get a better look. A software bill of materials, or SBOM for short, is like an ingredient list on a food product. It's there to tell you what other software was used to make that software, often for the sake of making sure the whole package follows proper licensing procedures. But it can also be like the NFPA label for describing a given material's hazards, since it can also contain information about known vulnerabilities in a piece of software. So it doesn't just tell you what's in there, it can also tell you what to look out for. So now let's take a look at the process of generating SBOMs for a given software project. Now, as an example, I'll use a project I've shown off here from time to time. It's my implementation of Conway's Game of Life written in Python. So it uses Python itself, some graphics libraries with Python, and a C compiled module. Now, for any project, regardless of language, there are two basic ways that we can generate an SBOM. One is by analyzing the source code. Another is to analyze a deployed binary artifact, a redistributable created by building from source. So if you're the developer and you're the one with access to the source, you can generate your SBOM by source analysis. In this case, I'm going to use a Python-specific tool called SBOM for Python, and I run it by providing it the requirements.txt file for my Python application, which lists all of its dependencies. So the analysis will take this and analyze all of the immediate dependencies required by the application. So that would be the graphics library Piglet and the library Cython, which is used to compile Python to C. But note that in this, there is no mention of the version of Python used or the C compiler that Cython builds the modules with, because those are technically not part of the source itself. So it's worth understanding the details that you get from a source analysis are going to be limited to the most immediate dependencies. Now, the second way that you can generate an SBOM is by way of binary analysis, by analyzing the redistributable artifact created for other people to use. I built just such an artifact from my Conway's Game of Life program. I've done it mostly by hand, by bundling the code and its needed libraries with an instance of Python. Now, to do the analysis of this whole package, I have a tool developed in my Microsoft called SBOM Tool. And this analyzes projects based on both their built binaries and optionally their source code. It generates an SBOM with details gleaned from both of them. Now, when I run this tool on my Conway's Game of Life project, it takes a fair amount of time to perform the analysis. It's going to take about 14 seconds, which I have edited down here for clarity. When it's done, though, you'll see a detailed breakdown of which sources it was able to discover and what languages or runtimes they belong to. In this case, we have many things discovered through Python's pip mechanism, which is used for installing packages to Python, but the tool also contains detections for Python's poetry system for managing packages, if you happen to be using that. And for many other languages like Rust and Go and Java, it can detect components from there as well. The resulting SBOM is a lot bigger than the one we generated internally from source. And that's because this SBOM also includes details about every binary included with the redistributable, both the binaries pre-compiled with our Python runtime and the binaries that we've built just now with Cython. And each file is fingerprinted, so different builds may result in a different hash set. So generating an SBOM should be part of any automated build process for a release. So that's the quick introduction to SBOMs. They tell you what other software a given software product contains, typically for the sake of license compliance, but also for security. And you can generate them directly from a project source, by binary analysis, or a mix of the two for the most detailed results. That's it for this episode. If you liked it, leave a comment below. And don't forget to follow Dev with Sirdar and InfoWorld on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com. We'll be right back.